Macy Godonsi. He drew the window again in the rain in the garden. But this time, she used paint, which made it look magical and enchanted with the candles next to the window. And another one. The window, the rain, the garden. But this time, they used watercolors. It was made by two people. Delancey Graves and David Hahn. They used watercolors to paint the magnificent picture. They used watercolors to paint the magnificent window. Watercolors to paint the magnificent candles and the rain and the garden. Next to the papers, you find art supplies. Newly sharpened pencils and dull ones. Washed paintbrushes and unwashed. And paint sets. Brand new paint sets. They're begging you. Begging you to draw the rainy window and the garden and the candles. You pick up one of the blank pieces of paper and write your name at the bottom. Then you sit in the wooden chair next to the dresser and begin to start drawing the window. Only using pencil for now. Perhaps the first artist who had drawn in pencil did not have enough time to draw the rest of the window and paint it. Perhaps the rain had stopped, and he felt that he wasn't allowed to paint when there wasn't rain. Perhaps that's how you felt. You began sketching out the window. Making sure you got the right flicker of the candle. The right shape of the leaves outside the window. Clouds. You even added the box with the golden lock and the golden key. When you were done, you didn't feel the need to paint it. The drawing spoke for itself, and you put it away with the others. You were about to close the wooden box when inside, beside the glass raindrops, was a paper that you hadn't noticed before. You only noticed it now, because of your drawing. You wanted to get every detail right of the window and the dresser. You took out the paper, and it read, Rainy Inn is a very magical place. I'm sure you can agree. So to remember this place, take as many glass raindrops as you want. And leave a drawing. Signed, Rainy Inn. You didn't want to take more than one of the magical, mystical, glass raindrops. You picked out the smallest one, and even though it may have been the smallest, it was the perfect size to fit in your pocket. It was round on the bottom and smooth, with a beautiful blue color. And on the top, the blue color got lighter and was pointy. But not that pointy. It ended in a curved shape. You put it gently in your pocket. And you thought to yourself, this place really is magical. And indeed, you were right. You closed the lid on the brown box. You locked it with the golden key. You put the golden key next to it and stared out the window at the garden, at the rain, at the beauty.